Today we will be going over the device menu for the Model 30, Model 35, and Model 79. To enter the device menu, the instrument will need to be off. Then turn the instrument on. The first screen you will see will be the startup screen, followed by the firmware version and the battery voltage. Finally, the normal operation screen will be displayed. Once it is, you have a 4-second window to press the mode button 3 times to access the device menu. Once in the device menu, you will see DET, or the detector page, displayed. Inside the detector page, you will find the high voltage setting, the current overload setting, response time, count time, and enabled modes. The next screen you can access by pressing the mode button is the channel 1. This will contain calibration specific data like the calibration constant, the dead time correction, efficiency, threshold, and loss of count timers. Pressing the mode button once more will activate the U-1 page, which contains all your primary unit selections. By pressing the units button, I will enter into that. Currently I have R per hour flashing. Pressing the mode button will increment that to a different unit, like sievert per hour. Pressing the OK button will allow you to set up the minimum display. As you can see, it says millisieverts per hour now with 1 decimal place. To change that, I'm going to press the mode button. The decimal went away. Press it again. It says sieverts per hour with 2 decimals. And again, now I have a microsievert per hour display with 1 decimal position. Pressing the units button one more time will advance to the next screen, which shows a maximum display of 1 sievert per hour. We're going to go ahead and change that to 500 millisieverts. To do that, I'm going to use the OK button to move left and the mode button to increment my desired number up. Now my unit and decimal are selected. I will again use the mode button until millisieverts with no decimal place is displayed. Like so. Pressing the units button again will advance me to the alert, which is currently set for 20 millisieverts per hour, which is okay. Pressing the units button again will move me to the alarm, which is currently set to 50 millisieverts per hour, which is again okay. Holding the units button for a long press will return me to the page selection. Pressing the mode button will advance me to the Unit 2 selection, which contains everything that was in Unit 1, but for Unit 2. Pressing the mode button again will move me to the INS page, or instrument page. Inside this page, you will find the audio mode, audio volume, automatic shutdown, and your green LED options. Pressing the mode button once more will take you to the RTC, or real-time clock. Once you enter into this menu, none of these parameters are changeable through the device menu. It will only display the device date time. Holding the units button again for a long press will return you to the page selection. Holding it for a long press again will exit the menu and save your changes that you just made. Inside our device manual, you will find a detailed list of all the parameters and which page they are located in.